to miss it.
You know, it's something. It's something when a bad company gets the government to do its bidding. It's also something when a guy who runs a bad company says some stuff about a friend of mine that I don't really care for. This is Herb Greenberg. He's writes for Market Watch, owned by the Journal. He writes for he comes on CNBC. Herb Greenberg, you've been in the game for a long time, longer than I have. How's it feel to be called a crooked reporter on CNBC?
It feels like the person who called me a crooked reporter on CNBC, Patrick Byrne, for the third time, has libeled me, has defamed me, has slandered me, is getting in the way of me doing my job. He's getting.
Well, aren't you taking money from the shorts? I mean, ain't that the game? Isn't that the game that he just portrayed you as?
Yeah, exactly. That's exactly what he said. Yet he has absolutely no proof. What he claims he has here, what Patrick Byrne claims he has, is affidavits that were filed in connection with the lawsuit. As I have written in my column on MarketWatch, these affidavits, which were given under the legally, they would be committing perjury if they were a lie. Are a lie. What they wrote. And so Patrick is going around handing out. He's handing these things out to people before they're even filed with the law, with the courts. I got to tell you something.
Yeah.
It is a sham. It is the ultimate.
Well, you know, I got the subpoena from the government last week, too.
Did you?
Here's my copy. Yeah, I got it. You know why I got the subpoena? I got the subpoena because I've said negative things about a stock that I think is going lower. That's why I got that subpoena. I didn't get the subpoena because I'm corrupt and crooked like you. Right?
Let me tell you something, buddy.
That's why you got a subpoena from the United States government, because you and I both tried to get people out of a stock that we said was going lower that then went lower, and the thanks that we get, I'm not looking for the Congressional Medal of Investing, but to get a subpoena?
Let me tell you something, buddy boy. The issue here is that what I do for a living is I help people avoid getting taken advantage of. I help them avoid losing money.
Well, who would ever talk to you again if they knew that all that was going to happen was that you were going to tell the government exactly you talked to you and what they said?
Wait a minute. It goes beyond that. Who in the world is going to talk to me if they're worried that for talking to me and maybe going on the record, they're going to get subpoenaed? Jim, I'm going to tell you one thing. That kind of thing happening when it comes to the press isn't going to happen on my watch. Mm. It is not going to happen.
Well, it seems like they've backed away from you.
You know what's interesting here? The funny thing about this whole thing is, when it comes to looking at companies, the SEC and I, we're sort of doing the same thing. You're trying to be out there policing public companies. These mm-hmm. are public companies. People put their stock in these companies. But what's really going on is there's a conspiracy. There's another conspiracy. There is the real conspiracy, if there's a conspiracy, is a conspiracy by these people to try to silence the critics.
Well, how brilliant is it, though? You see, you get this subpoena, and you know what the first thing your lawyer says to you? Jim, you can't talk about overstock anymore. I'm sure you're a lawyer. Well, you work at the Journal.
No, actually, you know what? I have a great lawyer. You know what my lawyer said? As long as it's newsworthy, write about it. As a matter of fact, I wrote about the subpoena the other day. And I'll keep writing about overstock and anything related to these companies.
But it is brilliant. You got a company that's losing money hand over fist that nobody respects anymore. And what you do is you go to an office of the federal government and you say, listen, I want all the people who write negative stories that are all crooks and I want you to investigate. And they go and do it.
Here's what else happens. You don't just do it. Now you've got all the people who've been upset about what I've written all these years coming out. Right. And they're all patting each other on the back and they're filing this BioVail lawsuit. It's all tied to the same thing as this whole concept of trying to make sure we can make it so this guy can't do his job anymore. Well, let me tell you something. You know, I'm proud of what I do. I live in a great country that gives me great freedoms.
Look, I have been pro-prosecution all my life. I know they don't get the names out of the phone book.
If you're breaking the law, they ought to go get you.
I question the Fourth Amendment. But I got to tell you something. When you get a subpoena, because you got people out of a stock that was sinking like a stone, why is that bad?
Just tell me something. How can a guy go on television and constantly say the same thing, the same lie over and over and over again? And the reality is his stock fell the day he put out a press release that said his profit margins weren't going to be what people thought. And from that point on, analysts started cutting estimates.
Isn't it a better story, though, to say that Herb Greenberg's corrupt than to explain the losses? Isn't that an easier story to tell?
Classic shell game. Classic divert attention from this. Put it over here. First, it's something called naked shorts.
Right.
Then it's something called unfair business practices. Right. Then it's this. Then it's that. These guys can't get their message straight. Right. They're trying to.
Listen, buddy, you're not corrupt. I defend you.
Hey.
I defend your organization.
Hey, thank you, Jim.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Sure.
Herb Greenberg, MarketWatch.